Hallelujah. Are you ready for the word of God? Turn with me to the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 13 through 14. Ecclesiastes 12.
Twende pamoja katika kitabu cha Mhubiri 12.
All right, let's read together. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is man all. Verse 14, for God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil.
Mstari wa 13 na 14, hii ndio jumla ya maneno yote yamekwisha sikiwa. Mche Mungu nawe uzishike amri zake, maana kwa jumla ndiyo impasayo mtu. Kwa maana Mungu ataleta hukumuni kila kazi pamoja na kila neno la siri likiwa jema au likiwa baya.
I want to begin from where I left at several Sundays ago.
Anataka kuanzia mahali aliacha Jumapili zilizopita,
where I ministered to us on a message entitled Fear and Obedience in His Glory.
Alipotuletea ujumbe unaosema hofu na kumtii kwa ajili ya utukufu wake.
And I want to let us understand a few things here.
Nataka tuelewe mambo kadhaa hapa.
There can never be a meaning in life if there are no rules to the ones living the life.
Na maisha itakuwa haina maana kama hakuna sheria.
And what we've just read in Ecclesiastes,
na mahali tumesoma kitabu cha Mhubiri,
we've just understood that there are two crucial words as we learned several weeks ago.
Tumefahamu ya kwamba kuna maneno mawili muhimu kama vile tulivyojifundisha.
And those words are fear or reverence and obedience.
Na hayo maneno ni kumcha na hofu.
The Bible says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is man's all.
Mche Mungu nawe uzishike amri zake, maana kwa jumla ndiyo impasayo mtu.
So we are called to give reverence and to obey, for that is why you were created. Nothing else. If you thought you were created to make money, if you thought you were created to marry and give birth to children, you are thinking the wrong way. You were created to fear God and honor his commands.
Wewe uliumbwa kumcha Mungu na kutii amri zake.
All the other things that you've been chasing are an overflow of obedience and submission to his word.
Na yale mambo yote ambayo unafuatilia yamekuwa tu ni zaidi ya utiifu.
And I want us to go directly to that which governs those who fear and obey God.
Nataka tuende moja kwa moja kwa kile kinacho watawala na kuwaongoza wale wanaomcha na kumwona
hofu ya Mungu. Who give reverence to God and obey him.
Na wale ambao humcha Mungu na kumtii.
I want you to understand this.
Nataka ufahamu haya.
In order for you to obey,
ili ukaweze kutii,
there must be sets of rules to be obeyed.
Ni lazima kuwe kuna sheria za kutii.
Even in the house that you live in.
Hata kwa ile nyumba unaishi.
I understand that in most of your houses, whether it's well cemented or not, when people come in, they leave their shoes outside.
Kwa nyumba za watu wengi, huwa ukiingia unatoa viatu.
There's the rule that governs taking a shower. When you go to take a shower, you have to remove your clothes.
Na kuna sheria ukiingia bafu kuoga ni lazima ukaweze kuvua nguo.
There are rules that governs eating. You cannot eating while jumping up and down. You might get choked.
Na kuna sheria zinazokuongoza wakati wa kula, huwezi ukakula na kuruka.
There are rules that governs the entire world that there is gravity, and if you don't obey gravity, we might bury you very soon.
Na kuna sheria na miongozo ya kidunia kama mvuto wa ardhi.
So if you decide to be Superman today and climb a a story and fly because you think you can, we'll start forming a committee or burial committee before you land.
Na ukipanda gorofa na ujiachilie.
You can't defy the laws of gravity.
Hawezi kuenda kinyume na nguvu za mvuto wa dunia.
For you to sit here, you have to be obedient to some rules that governs you being seated.
Ili ukaweze kuketi hapo ni lazima ukaweze kuwa mtiifu wa sheria.
And therefore today we need to ask ourselves, in order to be pleasing to God, what rules must we follow?
Kwa hivyo leo inatupasa tujiulize ili tukaweze kumfuata na kumtii Mungu ni sheria gani inatupasa kuzifuata.
The last time I ministered I shared about two rules.
Wakati uliopita alishiriki sheria mbili.
Thou shall not have any other gods before me.
Hautakuwa na miungu, hautakuwa na miungu mingine mbele yangu badala yangu.
And God said, thou shalt not make unto thyself any graven image of anything that is in heaven above, or in the earth beneath, or in the water under the earth. You shall not make anything that looks like something that is in heaven.
Nawe hutajichongea sanamu mfano mbinguni, duniani ama chini ya maji.
That is the second commandment.
Hiyo ndiyo amri ya pili.
And God in his infinite wisdom realized that you are very stubborn people. He continued on the second commandment and said, thou shalt not bow unto them.
Na katika amri ya pili anasema hautawasujudu.
And he said, for I the Lord your God, I am a jealous God.
Kwa maana mimi Mungu wenu ni mwenye wivu.
And listen to what he finalizes that second commandment with, that he will pass on that curse and anger to the third and fourth generation of those who bows down to that which looks like something in heaven.
Naye anatamatisha kwa kusema nitawapatiliza vizazi vijavyo la ana zenu.
Listen.
Sikiliza.
Thou shall not make any graven image of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shall not even dare bow down to them. This second commandment is one of the broken commandment at will.
Na amri ya pili ya kutojichongea sanamu mfano wa mbinguni wala duniani ndiyo amri inayovunjwa sana.
And I shared with us and I said, all of us are guilty of this.
Na akashiriki na kutuambia kwamba sote tumeivunja.
For instance,
kwa mfano,
how many of us have prayed for a job and you got it, whether business or employment?
Ni wangapi wameomba wapate kazi ama biashara?
Only me, Mary and Davis.
Na wakapata.
Okay, just a few of us. How many of us have found ourselves under pressure to bow down to the rules even on Sunday and we break the Sabbath day?
Ni wangapi wamejipata katika msukumo wa kuvunja sheria ya Sabato?
Thou shall not bow down and worship them. How many of us, this is the, we are learning the Ten Commandments, church.
Tunajifundisha amri kumi.
We are told to follow his commandments. Honor God, fear God, and obey his commandments. Here are the commandments, number one, number two, I've spelled them out. How many of us have found ourselves desiring never to report to work late?
Ni wangapi kati yetu wametamani kutochelewa
kwenda kazini?
Even
if you never slept last night, you still wake up early. Eri ukadozi ukifanya job, but you are at work early. Let me see by a show of hand.
Ni wangapi hawataki
hata shule, hata shule.
Utaki kuchelewa.
Whether the boss is there or not. But how many of us stroll to church when the church is supposed to start at 9:15? You stroll at 9:05 to 10. Hallelujah, tumefika.
Ni wangapi wanakuja kuchelewa kanisani?
And you start singing from the gate. Baba, niko hapa. Baba, niko hapa.
Dio.
Baba, niko hapa. Niko hapa. Kwa ajili ya, really? If you don't stroll to work, why stroll in his presence?
Kama hauvuti miguu ukienda kazini, kwa nini unajivuta na kujikokota
ukienda kanisani? Are we not bowing down to graven image? Your work is an image.
Je, hausujudu sanamu? Maana kazi yako inakuwa ni sanamu.
I'm not saying you should not go to work. Go, but give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give to God what belongs to God.
Ni muhimu kwenda kazini, lakini mpatie Kaisari yaliyo Kaisari, na ya Mungu mpatie Mungu.
You can never find yourself trying to adjust your work schedule, but you find yourself adjusting cell meetings, adjusting going to church, adjusting anything pertaining to God. This is a clear sign of deviating from your call.
Na ukijipata unaanza kupanga kupangilia vile unaenda kanisani, hii ni kujitoa katika mipango.
Oh, I wish those who took their children to school were here today, not because they disobey, but because I need everyone to hear this.
Anatamani Hallelujah. Sana wale wamepeleka watoto shuleni wakaweze kuwa hapa siku ya leo.
Let's read Deuteronomy chapter 6, chapter 5 from verse 6. Let's go there. Deuteronomy chapter 5 verse 6. I'm going to quote very few commandments, then we are going to go home happy, and Sunday will be here, and during the week we'll be in cell. Sema bwana asifiwe.
Kumbukumbu la Torati 5:6.
5:6, let's read it together. I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Stop.
Mimi ni Bwana Mungu wako niliyekutoa katika nchi ya Misri, katika nyumba ya utumwa.
This is what God is telling us, as he told the children of Israel. I'm the same God who responded when you needed a job. I'm the same God who responded when you are so broke and in debt, and today you can claim you are free and you are enjoying life. Salary is increasing and everything is happening. I'm the same God. I've not changed. Question is, have you changed?
Ni Mungu yule yule ambaye alikuwa pale wakati ukitafuta kazi na kwamba hauna hela. Na anasema hajabadilika.
I'm the same God who used to enter into the temple and cry, and I would listen to you with the mucus flowing. You didn't care, lying on the floor, calling upon my name, and I answered you. I'm still the same God. My question is, are you still interceding because you have or you went mute?
Je, bado unasimama katika mahali pa zamu kuomba?
Then he continues in verse 7, take me. You shall have no other gods before me. When he reminds you he has not changed, he tells you, leave any other god and see me as your God. The God who was there when you needed him most has not changed. Why have you changed?
Yule Mungu ulikuwa unamhitaji wakati uko kwa hali ngumu hajabadilika, kwa nini wewe umebadilika?
Verse 8. You shall not make for yourself a carved image of any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth.
Usijifanyie sanamu ya kuchonga mfano wa kitu chochote kilicho juu mbinguni au kilicho chini duniani.
You shall not bow down to them nor serve them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me.
Usivisujudie wala kuvitumikia, kwa kuwa mimi Bwana Mungu wako ni Mungu mwenye wivu, na wapatiliza wana wa uovu wa baba zao.
But showing mercy to thousands, to those who love me and keep my commandments.
Nami na warehemu maelfu elfu wanipendao na kuzishika amri zangu.
Go back to verse 10.
Stari wa 10.
If he can pass a curse, he's trying to tell you, I can still give a blessing.
Kama anaweza kupatiliza laana, hata anaweza kupeana baraka.
Why do you become so selfish and break the first two so that you can enjoy life at the expense of the children that are coming?
Kwa nini unakuwa mbinafsi wa kuvunja amri mbili za kwanza?
If you tell me it's my life, unajua life mtu anaishi vile anapenda. Sio yako, you are living for the next generation. You are passing away. They are just starting life. Live the correct way of living, and those children will be blessed.
Maisha unayoishi si yako tu, ni ya vizazi vijavyo pia.
I knew there will be no amen in this congregation, but I know there is an amen within me. Hallelujah.
Kuna amen. Hallelujah. Ndani yake.
Verse 11, 12. We are in verse 12. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. That is the third commandment. Listen.
Hiyo ndio amri ya tatu.
There is a tendency in the Gen Zs, and now the Gen Zs, because we've accepted to be led by them, have affected us. Now, how many of you have found yourself saying, walai?
Ni wangapi wamejipata wakisema walai?
Aki walai. Sikudanganyi walai. Let me show. Okay. Wanaswe sana. What is that verse saying? Can we read it again? Verse 11. The third commandment. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. For the Lord will not hold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. Let me tell you, we are all guilty.
Sote tumevunja hiyo amri.
Aki ya Mungu. Vile nakwambia ni ukweli. Aki ya Mungu. In the New Testament you say, you are told, let your yes be yes and your no be no. Listen, the fact that you're in Mombasa doesn't give you the right to call the name of the Lord your God in vain. Silence it, if possible.
Kama uko Mombasa haikupati haki ya kulitaja bure jina la Bwana Mungu wako.
And then you start asking, mbona ninafanyanga hivi na sifaulu? Mbona God is finding you guilty and is judging you amongst those who are guilty in any other way.
Mungu anakupata na hatia naye anakuhukumu sawa na walio na hatia.
My friend, let it not be mentioned in your mouth. You will continue to pile judgment upon your life.
Usilitaje bure jina la Bwana Mungu wako manake utapatikana na hatia.
Verse 13. It says, roll over. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work. We are in the fifth commandment, isn't it? Huh? We are in the fifth commandment. Read it with me. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God. In it you shall do no work. You nor your sons, nor your daughters, nor your male servant, nor your female servant, nor your ox, nor your donkey, nor any of your cattle, nor your stranger who is within your gates, that your male servant and your female servant may rest as well as you.
Siku sita fanya kazi, utende mambo yako yote, lakini siku ya saba ni sabato ya Bwana Mungu wako, siku hiyo usifanye kazi yoyote, wewe wala mwanao, wala binti yako, wala mtumwa wako, wala mjakazi wako, wala ng'ombe wako, wala punda wako, wala mnyama wako yeyote, wala mgeni aliye ndani ya malango yako, ili mtumwa wako na mjakazi wako wapumzike vile vile kama wewe.
That's the fourth commandment.
Hiyo ni ya nne.
Let's repeat again. The first commandment, they shall not have any other gods.
Utakuwa na miungu mingine.
Second commandment, thou shalt not make unto thyself any graven image. Commandment number three, do not swear in the name of your, do not mention the name of your Lord, the Lord your God in vain.
Usilitaje bure jina la Bwana Mungu wako.
Number four, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. How many of you have said, mi nimeokoka, lakini ule nimeuaga naandika hata watu wale wa mjengo, unajua hajaokoka. Jua hajaokoka, wacha tu afanye kazi, hata nisipowapatia bado watafanya kwingine. How many have found yourself doing that? Even your house help, even anything, you've given them work on Sunday, there is the commandment, let them rest as you rest.
Waache wapumzike kama vile unavyopumzika.
Give them an off day.
Patia siku ya kupumzika.
We are getting the rules that governs us.
Tunapata zile sheria zinazotuongoza.
As a people who call upon the name of the living God.
Kama watu wanaoliitia jina la Bwana Mungu aliye hai.
These commandments are what should guide the church. It's the ladder that guides the church.
Na hii ndio nguzo inayoongoza kanisa.
I know some of you are saying, unajua hiyo ni Old Testament. Pasi unajua tuko kwa new dispense, eh? New dispensation ya the New Testament. Tuko kwa grace. Eh, kuwa tu kwa grace. Hata mercy yuko, sio grace peke yake. I understand. But the rules that are in place are rules to be followed. Hallelujah.
Zile sheria zimewekwa ziko hapo ili tuzifuate.
If you don't follow them, one to you. Jesus did not come to do away with the law, but to strengthen it. Hallelujah.
Kama hauzifuati ole wako kwa maana Kristo alikuja si kuvunja sheria lakini kuzitia nguvu.
I want you to notice something. All the four commandments,
amri zote nne,
have to do with what you do to God.
Inaelekeza ama zinahusu vile ufanye mbele ya Mungu.
It's not what you do to yourself or to other persons. It is what you do to God.
Kile unafanyia Mungu.
Are you getting what I'm saying? The remaining six commandments have nothing to do with God, but to do with fellow man.
Na zile amri sita zimebaki hazihusu Mungu, lakini zinahusu mwanadamu mwenzako.
It's interesting. Rules that governs what we do towards God are fewer than the rules that governs us towards each other.
Na zile sheria za kuhusu Mungu ni kidogo kuliko zile sheria zinazotuongoza kuishi na binadamu wengine.
Six good commandments that concerns what I do towards that child, towards you, and towards fellow neighbors that I know nothing about.
Kuna sheria sita zinazoniongoza namna ya kuishi na jirani ama mtu ambaye simfahamu.
And it's no wonder it starts with the fifth commandment that says, honor your father and mother so that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God giveth thee.
Ndiposa inaanza umuheshimu baba yako na mama yako ili siku zako zikaweze kuwa nyingi.
Isn't it interesting? In verse 16, he starts by saying, honor your father and mother.
Waheshimu baba yako na mama yako.
Meaning, your father and mother are closer to God than your neighbor. Hello?
Inamaanisha baba na mama yako wako karibu na Mungu kuliko jirani.
After doing right to your God, the next person who is close to him is your father and your mother.
Baada ya kufanya sahihi kwa Mungu, yule mtu aliye karibu naye ni baba na mama.
There is the biological father.
Kuna baba wa kihalisi ama
kijinsia. There is a father and a mother who maybe adopted you.
Na kuna baba na mama walio kuchukua na kukulea.
We have spiritual fathers.
Na kuna baba wa kiroho.
Who become fathers even to your father and mother.
Unakuwa baba kwa baba zako.
And we have different types of fathers.
Kuna baba aina nyingi.
In other words, honor those who are in authority.
Kwa maneno mengine waheshimu walio kwa mamlaka.
Somebody listening to me. Romans 13:1. Everyone must submit to the governing authority, for there is no authority except that which God has established. All authority have been established by God.
Warumi 13, heshimu sheria na walio katika mamlaka, kwa maana hakuna mamlaka ambayo haijathibitishwa na Mungu.
In other words, God is trying to tell us in these commandments, I work through delegated authority. After you've honored me, honor those who have put above you to guide you, to nurture you, to raise you up, to correct you. Honor them. The word honor here simply means elevate above the rest.
Na hilo neno kuheshimu linamaanisha uinue juu.
Don't mistake the word honor here with the Chinese one. I honor you. No. Bowing down is not honor. I'm talking about in everything you do, you elevate. When you are parents, when you're whichever level of parents, when they give you instructions, you lift that instruction to a level above the rest.
Ukipatiwa mwongozo na mzazi unainua.
That when your father calls or your mother calls, even if the president calls, you first think of your mother and your father and you tell the king. You remember there's one rich ruler who came and to the Lord and said, I would like to follow you. And the Lord said, yeah, you can follow me. And he said, let me go and bury my father and then I'll come and follow you.
Na yule kiongozi mmoja anataka kumfuata Yesu akasema wacha nikamzike baba yangu.
He wanted to twist that law to give a reason as to why not to follow Christ. And Christ said, it doesn't work like that. He was lying. You see, if your father is dead, what are you doing in the market? The guy was lying.
Mm-hmm.
When a parent dies, you don't go to the market. You don't go to the city. You mourn until you bury. So the guy was not truthful.
Mzazi akiaga hauendi shughuli.
Never use God's laws to suit what you think is right. Use them to please him and what he stands with as right.
Is somebody listening to me? Kuzifanyia vile vinavyokupendeza.
Now honor your father and mother. Elevate your parents, whether spiritual or whoever is in authority over your life. Elevate their word. Honor them and let's see which door will be closed before you.
Na waheshimu wazazi wako na wale walio na mamlaka.
The Bible says this is the only command with a promise.
Na hii ndio amri yenye ahadi.
No other command has a promise. Every other command, it's either you undertake it or you are judged for not undertaking it.
Kila amri ni aidha uifuate ama ukikosa kuifuata hukumiwe.
But this one you are told so that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God gives you.
Na hii inasema ili siku zake zikaweze kuwa nyingi katika ile inchi Bwana anayokupatia.
And do not think that the law was outlawed by the New Testament.
Mnasifahamu au siamini kwamba ile sheria imekuwa sasa haifanyi kazi.
Romans chapter 7 verse 7.
Warumi 7:7.
What shall we say then? Is the law sin? Certainly not. On the contrary. On the contrary, I would not have known sin except through the law. For I would not have known covetousness unless the law had said, you shall not covet.
Tusemeje basi torati ni dhambi? Hasha, walakini singalitambua dhambi ila kwa sheria. Kwa kuwa singalijua kutamani kama torati isingalisema usitamani.
He starts by saying in verse 1 that I speak to those who know the law.
Anaanza kwa kusema mstari wa kwanza ninazungumzia wale wanaofahamu sheria.
And he starts by saying that the law has dominion over the person so long as they live.
Na anazungumzia na kusema kwamba ile sheria inatawala wale watu wanaoishi.
You see, so long as we are alive,
ilimradi uko hai,
and we serve this God,
na tunamtumikia huyu Mungu,
we are supposed to live according to the rules and laws that governs us being in his presence.
Inatupasa tuishi kulingana na sheria zinazotuongoza namna ya kuishi katika uwepo wake.
Yesterday I had very important people in my house.
Jana alikuwa na watu muhimu kwake.
And I'm going to use this illustration because they will understand what I mean.
Anaenda kutumia huu mfano kwa maana watafahamu.
They came as a family to visit us. They came to my house to visit us as a family.
Walikuja kuwatembelea kama familia.
And the first thing I noticed when they arrived, they removed their shoes. Nobody told them to remove them.
Na jambo la kwanza walitoa viatu na hakuna mtu alikuwa
amewaambia. No voice came from heaven saying, this family, remove your shoes for the place you are entering is holy. No, there was no Moses moment.
Hakuna sauti iliyo wakujia kuambia watoe viatu.
They removed their shoes.
Wakatoa viatu.
They entered, we greeted them.
Wakaingia na wakawasalimu.
And then we started chatting.
Wakaanza kuzungumza.
All this time they were not sitting. And my wife said, please have a seat.
Na akawaambia tafadhali ketini.
And they sat down.
Na wakaketi.
In other words, they knew that the rules that govern that house might be different from the rule that governs their home. So they were waiting to know what governs here. Do we sit here ama tutambua bedroom ama kitchen? You know, you have to wait. When you go to someone's house, you live by their rules, isn't it?
Ukienda kwa tembelea kwa wengine, unaishi kulingana na sheria zao.
You don't do whatever you want.
Haufanyi chenye unataka.
Even in your own house, you are governed by the rules of that house. The time to eat, the time to sleep, the time to wake up. Every house has its own rules, true or false?
Kila nyumba iko na sheria zake.
Why do you want to live the way we want in the presence of God?
Kwa nini tunataka tuishi vile tunajihisi mbele za Mungu?
Oh, freedom! There's freedom in the presence of God. You can do whatever you want, somersault, sleep whenever you want. No. Rules still applies.
Sheria bado zifuatiliwe.
Tell your neighbor, thou shalt not have any other gods before me.
Hautakuwa na miungu mingine ila mimi.
Tell your neighbor, thou shalt not make any graven image of anything. Inasema nini? Of any likeness of anything that is in heaven above or in the earth beneath. Usijifanyie sanamu ya kuchonga ya kitu chochote kilicho juu mbinguni wala chini duniani wala chini ya maji huko. Don't.
Usifanye.
Are we together? Commandment number 3. Thou shalt not mention the name of the Lord your God in vain. Commandment number 4. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Siku ya Sabato.
Commandment number 5. Honor your father and mother so that your days may be long in the land that the Lord your God does what? Giveth thee. Now listen.
Waheshimu baba yako na mama yako.
These 6 commandments we are now talking about.
Hii ya sita tunayozungumzia.
That pertains what we do to one another.
Ambayo inahusu vile tunafanyiana.
They are to be observed carefully.
Ni lazima ukaweze kuifuata kwa makini.
Because they are meant to reveal God to the person that we live with.
Kwa maana inakusudiwa kumthibitisha Mungu kwa yule mtu.
They are not meant to show how holy you are. They are there to reveal God to the other person.
Ziko pale kuashiria Mungu kwa yule mtu.
Listen to Romans 13 verse 9. Romans 13 verse 9. For the commandment, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, you shall not covet. And if there is any other commandment are all summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
Stari wa 9, maana kule kusema usizini, usiue, usiibe, usitamani, na ikiwapo amri nyingine yoyote, inajumlishwa katika neno hili, ya kwamba mpende jirani yako kama nafsi yako.
Hallelujah. If I love you,
kiwa nakupenda,
I will not steal from you.
Sita kuibia.
If I love you, Rogers,
kiwa nakupenda, Rogers,
I will not take your wife from you.
Sita chukua mke wako.
If I love you,
kama nakupenda,
I will not hate your children.
Sita wachukia watoto.
So love covers everything.
Hiyo inashikilia kila kitu.
No wonder the Bible says love covers the multitude of sin.
Ndiposa Biblia inasema upendo huficha
wingi wa dhambi. When I love you, I will not give false witness against you.
Kama nakupenda sitashuhudia uongo.
The Bible says that thou shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. That's one of the commandments. Let's go through them very quickly because I want to wind up. It says from verse 16, honor your father and mother. Verse 17 says, you shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. Those are already 9 commandments.
Hizo ni amri 9.
But they are all covered in one commandment, love.
Lakini zote ziko chini ya amri moja, upendo.
Because if you love me, you will not murder me.
Kama unanipenda hautaniua.
Someone might ask, na mbona polisi wanaua watu? There's a difference between murdering and killing.
Kuna tofauti ya kuua.
There's a difference between murdering and killing. And I'm very sensitive because I have teachers in this church.
Kuna utofauti wa kuua mtu na kunyonga.
Murder ni kunyonga.
Leo.
Huh? There's a difference between murder and killing.
Kunyonga mtu na kuua.
A policeman might kill a thief. He's not murdering.
Yeye askari anaweza kuua mwizi.
Just like you can kill a stray dog that is biting your child. You're not murdering.
Naweza kuua mbwa anayejaribu kuuma mtoto.
You are keeping law and order. Is somebody listening to me?
Unatiisha amri ama watu wanafuata amri?
But when you murder, you can, you, To murder is to take an innocent soul away from it. I mean, you like Cain and Abel. Hello? Cain murdered, took an innocent soul, removed it without any just cause, without a reason. That's murder.
Kuua mtu asiyekuwa na hatia.
But that does not give you a license to say, amenikosea sana ndio nikamdunga knife. No, you are not to take law into your own hands. Have I confused anyone? Okay. All right. So don't tell me KDF walienda Somali, they have committed murder. No, they killed enemies.
Oh, waliua adui.
Are we together? They did not murder. Hello? Are we together? Now, let me finish. You need to understand a few things here. That God intends us to keep these commandments. And if we don't do that, you are actually in error, no matter how much you pray, worship, or sing. Perhaps the most interesting one is the 10th commandment. Read it with me in Exodus chapter 20, verse 17.
Kutoka 20.
Mstari wa 17. This is the most interesting one. I want you to read it with me as loud as you can. Let's do it. Nor his female servant, nor his ox, nor his donkey, nor anything that is your neighbor's. Thou shalt not covet.
Usitamani nyumba ya jirani yako, usimtamani mke wa jirani yako, wala mtumwa wake, wala mjakazi wake, wala ngombe wake, wala punda wake, wala chochote alicho nacho jirani yako.
All the other commandments.
Amri zingine.
Concerns outward actions.
Inahusu mambo ya inje.
Killing and all those stealing and all that.
Kuua, kuiba na mengineyo.
And you know, God is not interested in your physical but in your spiritual well-being.
Na ye Mungu hausiki na jinsia na hali yako ya kimwili lakini hali yako ya kiroho.
The 10th commandment more than any other commandment.
Amri ya kumi zaidi ya zote.
Reveals how sinful we are from the inside.
Inadhihirisha
how sinful we are on the inside.
To live yo na dhambi ndani mwetu.
And just reveals to us that everyone, just like Romans 3:23, have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God.
Hayo inadhihirisha kama vile Warumi 3:23 inasema kwamba sote tumetenda dhambi na kupungukiwa na utukufu.
Why is that so? Because the 10th commandment is dealing with our secret inner being.
Hiyo amri ya kumi inashughulikia usiri wa ndani mwetu.
It is dealing with the path that nobody can see.
Hiyo inashughulikia ile sehemu ambayo mtu hayoni.
It is dealing with the real you.
Hiyo inashughulikia wewe mwenyewe halisi kabisa.
Even if it's your father, your mother, your wife, your husband, when they are coveting, you may never know. Wanakanga tu kwa kusema hii ingekuwa tu yangu hii. Hii ako kasimu ni kazuri lakini mwenye kuwa nako hata akai. You know those kinds of words within you. Sasa huyu alitu ama ni ya kuiba. You are coveting.
Hiyo ni kutamani.
Nguo smart lakini mwenye kuvaa jameni, you are coveting. Hawa nao alitoa na wapi? Alitoa wapi jamaa mhandi hivi? Coveting. Hello? Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Ujaisikia covetousness in the spiritual way? Eh? Ujaisikia za kiroho? Baba nakushukuru kwa sababu ya hiyo KBN ya Robert. Bwana asifiwe sana. Najua utamgusa baba. Apande mbegu. Hallelujah. You're coveting. Let's be real. You're desiring something that belongs to someone.
Unatamani kitu ambacho ni cha mwingine.
There's a difference between appreciating and coveting until you are driven like, na mimi lazima nipate yangu. Anawezaje pata anishinde? You are coveting. You are worse than a murderer.
Wewe ni muovu zaidi ya muuaji.
Is somebody in church today? The 10th commandment is dealing with our inner self.
Amri ya kumi inashughulikia undani mwetu.
And therefore we need to concentrate on this.
Inatupasa tukaiangalie na kuizingatia.
And we need to really hold on fast to it.
Na inatupasa tukaweze kuishikilia.
And I want you to understand this.
Nataka ukaweze kufahamu.
All of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. If the 10th commandment will be the plumb line to measure whether we are right with God or not.
Sote tumepungukiwa na utukufu wa Mungu na kutenda dhambi ikiwa kigezo chetu ni amri kumi za Mungu.
And just to show the seriousness of the matter, Jesus stated something in Matthew 5:27. You see, you might think that I do not commit adultery. Sikuna moja hapo usizini. Huh?
Ndio.
Thou shall not commit adultery. Is there say, mimi silalangi nje. God is showing you the seriousness of the last five. Because the sixth one ni tunasoma ya 10. Now he's showing you the seriousness of it in Matthew 5 verse 27 to verse 28. He says, you have heard that it was said to those of old, you shall not commit what? So Jesus is mentioning one of the commandments. It is said in the commandment, you shall not commit adultery, verse 28. But I say to you that whoever looks at a woman to lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart. What is Jesus trying to tell us?
Yesu anajaribu kutuambia nini?
That if I look at a lady even in this church and I start imagining beyond what I'm seeing, mimi na wazinifu na washerati tutapanga foleni moja wakati wa hukumu.
Ndio.
Somebody listening to me? And you tell me sini kuangalia tu nikafikiria, fine. You cannot go against the word of God. What Jesus is trying to tell us is that whatever sticks to your heart, which is the center of every human being, is what shall take you to hell if it is not right.
Kile kiko katika moyo wako, hiyo ndiyo kitakupeleka motoni kama hakiko sawa.
And all the men in the church, and I wish all of them were there. Listen, I'm not saying if you see someone beautiful, you don't comment. You can see someone beautiful and say, hey, na Virginia, you're beautiful. And it ends there. But if she's beautiful and you're going beyond that, my friend, we na shetani mko kwa mili moja, probably hata ukienda hell atakufukuza, akutengezeka hell kako juu unampatia kombe. It is that serious. Is somebody listening to me? There's nothing wrong with saying God's creation is beautiful. It becomes worse when you start putting it inside you until you start coveting and you start fantasizing and thinking of how you can grab it. And Jesus is saying you've already done it if you've already thought about it.
Umefanya hivyo wakati umetamani.
That is the seriousness of this 10th commandment.
Hivyo ndivyo amri kumi ziko na uzito.
For God's glory to be manifested in our lives,
utukufu wa Mungu kadhihirike maishani mwetu,
we must therefore guard our hearts at all times.
Ni lazima tukaweze kulinda mioyo yetu kila wakati.
Matthew 15 verse 19 as I finish to verse 20.
Mathayo 15.
Why must we guard our hearts at all times?
Kwa nini tukaweze kulinda mioyo yetu?
For out of the heart proceeds evil thoughts, murders, adultery, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man. Hallelujah.
Kwa maana moyoni hutoka mawazo mabaya, uuaji, uzinzi, uasherati, wivi, ushuhuda wa uongo na matukano. Hayo ndiyo yamtiayo mtu najisi.
But to eat with unwashed hands does not defile a man.
Lakini kula kabla hujanawa mikono hakumtii mtu najisi.
What is he trying to say? This dirt you see on the outside does not matter. The dirt on the inside is what counts.
Ule uchafu wa nje haujalishi, ule ulioko ndani ndio hatari.
As I call the entire church,
Napolita kanisa lote,
to go and sit down and go through the 10 commandments for the next 7 days.
ukaweze kuzisoma na kuzipitia amri kumi kwa siku saba zijazo.
Because they are meant to be in our hearts to replace covetousness, to replace all those spirits that harbor ill feelings. We need to replace them with the word of God.
Tukaweze kuziweka katika pale mahali ambapo nastahili.
Tell your neighbor, fear and obedience in his glory.
Kumcha Mungu na kumtii kwa utukufu wake.
And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Church of the living God, magnify the Lord in everything you do for his glory. God bless you.